We're kicking off a new series in the respiratory space. So to start, let's break down pulse oximetry and how this device works. This is used to measure oxygen saturation in one's blood. And you may be most familiar with the type that clips onto your finger. However, there's also types that are able to clip onto one's earlobe. If we zoom in on the device itself, it's composed first of a light emitter emitting infrared light, as well as a light detector. So when the finger is inside, in scenario one, if there's a lot of blood cells that are highly oxygenated, that infrared light is not going to be able to pass from the emitter to the detector, leading to an individual having high oxygen saturation. However, in scenario two, if some of the light from the emitter is able to pass to the detector, this would indicate that it's not being stopped by oxygenated blood, leading to an individual having low oxygen saturation. This type of device is used in routine checkups, medical support, or respiratory monitoring. However, it's important to recognize that there are limitations on this device based on skin darkness. Additionally, pulse oximetry can be used in sleep studies, but to learn much more about sleep and respiration, check out the free webinar in this video description below and stay connected to my channel and Dane Garvin.